Product Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we're doing a tool review on two items. The first one is this internal micrometer, stainless steel, and the second item is this live center with a number 2 Morse taper. So let's go into the workshop and take a closer look.
The temperature in the workshop today is about 9 degrees centigrade. Today we're having a look at this internal micrometer from Banggood. This is a 25 to 50 millimeter range. The body's made out of stainless steel. It comes with a 25 millimeter setting ring. It says on there 25. But you can't make it out very well, it's very faint. And an adjusting spanner to zero the datum line. You can lock the spindle by turning this small knurled screw.
So you have the 25mm ring gauge with the mic. It's opposite to a normal 0 to 25. As you would unscrew it, it closes down. As you screw it down, it opens up. Just put that on the ring gauge, get a nice feel. Have a look at the reading. You can see there 0 doesn't align with the line. So all you need to do is take the spanner on the body. Move the body round till the zero lines up.
Detailed instructions on how to adjust the micrometer can be found on the web page for the product. You can see that the zero is now in line with the datum mark. And that's a nice feel on the ring gauge. This micrometer has tungsten carbide tips.
The 25 to 50, the stainless steel body. You get the micrometers in a range from 5 to 30, 25 to 50, 50 to 75, and then 75 for 100. So there are four different micrometers. And if you're ordering one, be sure you have the right number on the order for the micrometer you want.
This part here is just a fixing screw, and it holds the leg onto the body and stops it twisting round. It also has a slot in the spindle to stop the other leg twisting. You can see the slot there along the spindle.
That this has a peg that goes into it. 25 to 50 bore micrometer.
Once you set the adjustment to zero with the ring gauge, The micrometer works well, and for $42, I think it's good value for money. We'll now move on to the second product, which is our number 2 Morse Taper Live Center. There's number 2 Morse taper on this end, and the centre has a short diameter here, so you can get your tool in closer to the centre. It looks nicely made. It's round and on the Morse taper, ground all round with the 60 degree point. Let's go over to the lathe, see how it fits in the tailstock, see if, what the run out is on the end. I have a number 2-3 Morse taper sleeve, and I want to use this to check the taper. As you can see, I already have an Morse taper fitted inside, and this has a center already machined into it. As the tang is not showing in the slot, if you put a drift in, it won't do anything. If you have this problem where the end of the taper is below the slot in the Morse taper sleeve, all you need to do is take a nut that fits into the slot like that, then put the drift through the slot on top of the nut, and when you press it, it'll push the taper out. You should be able to get the nut back out. I'm using this Morse taper adapter number 2-3. What I want to do is just check the taper. Well, this is a revolving center that we're looking at. First of all, I want to put a red line, red mark on the taper. Then use my sleeve just to see what the taper's like. As you can see there, it is touching all the way along the taper, and it's just removed the red mark. So we'll put that in the tailstock, and we'll see what the run out is like on this end. I'll just bring in the dial indicator onto the end, revolve this by hand, zero it there. That's 3 thou there. Each division is a 1/10 of a thou. That's just over 2.5 thou. Rotating on the outside. Now if you look at the point, the point is the main part that needs to run through, as that's in contact with your workpiece. Now that is... The run out on this end is around 0.3 thou. So obviously the point of the centre has been machined or ground after it's been assembled. You still have about 0.5 thou play in that. You go back to the outside. Oh, that's better. Run out on the outside. Zero that. It's about 2.5 thou. So let's compare that with another centre. So I've changed over to a centre that I use normally. It's quite an old one now, I've had it years. So let's have a look at the movement in that is 0.3 thou, over 0.3 thou, and rotating. It's about 1 thou on the rotating. It's hard to tell when I've got movement in that. Let's try another one. A couple of thou movements in the centre, and run out. It's about 0.5 thou again. So to sum up on the revolving centre or live centre, the run out on the tip, which is the part that comes into contact with the workpiece, is about 0.3, and the run out on the diameter is about 0.2. For the price of just over $26, I think it's good value for money, and we'll see how it performs when I use it in some of my projects. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was interesting. Hope you liked it. We'll see you next time on Enoch's Engineering.